Welcome. Today, let's proceed with where we stopped in the previous video. We proceed with matrices. So today, yesterday, we did determinant and operations involving 3x3 matrices. So today, we want to do what we call the inverse of 3x3 matrix. Of 3x3 matrices. And we also want to do application of matrices. Of matrices to solve simultaneous equations of three unknown. So we want to use matrices to solve equations of three unknown, and we also want to be able to get an inverse of 3x3 matrix. So for example, we first want to take a recall on how to get an inverse of a 2x2 matrix. Given a 2x2 matrix like A, B, C, D as the element to get the inverse, the first step you get the determinant. Determinant, so given matrix A is equal to this one, get the determinant. And determinant, which is actually the magnitude of A, is given as, magnitude of A is given as the leading diagonal, that's A, D, minus the reverse diagonal, that is C, B. So this one shall give you the determinant. Then to get the inverse, that is the inverse of A, shall be equal to 1 over the magnitude of A into, then you reverse the terminals, this one and this one you reverse. Then you change the signs of this one, that one shall be A. A will change you to D and D changes to A. Then you change the sign of B and the sign of C. So this one shall actually be the inverse, which can be written as the magnitude we are about to be this one, so it will be 1 over AD minus CB into the reversed one, that's in this order, shall be actually the inverse of this matrix. So we want to apply the same principle in solving for the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. So let's have this one as our matrix. Let's have matrix P to be equal to this one. So we want to solve for matrix P using this method, but this one in this case is a 3x3 matrix. So what we need, you need to form a 2x2 matrix from the 3x3 matrix. But the first step here, the first step we got the determinant. So we get the magnitude of P. So given that P, as we have there, is 2, 3, 4, negative 1, 2, negative 1, 3, negative 15, 6 as our P. So the first step you are told to get, find the inverse of P. Find the inverse of P. That's actually P inverse. So the first step one, get the magnitude. So step one is magnitude of P, which is actually the determinant. And then we have said that for determinant, you recall the sign array, that is positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. From this sign array, you form a 2x2 matrix from the 3x3 matrix using the sign. So you take the first point, let's use the first row. The sign is positive multiplied by 2 is 2. Into form a 2x2 matrix by closing the row and column of 2. You remain with this 2x2 matrix. That is 2, negative 1, negative 5, 6. Then the second element is 3 multiplied by the sign, which is negative, so it is negative 3 into, close the row and the column where 3 is, you end up with a 2x2 matrix, that is these two terms and these two terms, that is negative 1, negative 1, 3, 6. Then you go to the third term, that is 4, multiplied by the sign in the sign array, that is positive 4. Then you form a 2x2 matrix by the closing the row and the column of 4, you end up with negative 2, negative 1, 2, 3, negative 5. So you can commute the magnitude of those 2x2 matrices directly and sum them together. So that one shall be 2 into 2 by 6, that is 12, negative 5 times negative 1, that is positive 5, so minus 5. Then negative 3 into negative 1 by negative 6 gives us negative 6. Then 3 by negative 1 is negative 1. So minus negative 3 gives you a positive, so you add 3. in that format. Then the last one is positive 4 into negative 1 by negative 5 gives you 5. 2, 3 by 2 is 6, negative 6 in that format. So apply the principle that we have defined in this one to get the magnitude it is the leading diagonal minus the product of the reverse diagonal. So if you solve the parts, you get this is 2 into 7 minus 3 into negative 3 plus 4 into negative 1. So this one gives you 14. This by this is positive 9. This by this will give you negative 4. So in that format, this one gives us positive 21. Positive 19, sorry. This one gives you positive 19 in that format. Positive 19. So the magnitude of P is actually 19. So that's the magnitude, the determinant of that one. After getting the determinant, we need to form what we call the conjugate terms by first forming a 2x2 matrix for all the points. We call it what we call to form a cofactor matrix. Step one was to get the magnitude. Step two, form a cofactor matrix from P. Cofactor matrix. And the cofactor matrix, you just do more or less the same thing you are doing when getting the determinants, but you only take the sign array. Sign array is very important in matrices. So you take the sign array, and from the sign array, you form cofactor matrix. That's an independent 2x2 matrices. For example, at the first term, which is 2, you take a cofactor matrix in that you take the point, the sign of that point is positive. You write it positive. Then you form a 2x2 matrix. This time round, you assume the pre-multiplier that you are using in getting the determinant. So you don't add that pre-multiplier. You only take 2x2 matrix. So you come here, you close the row where 2 is and the column, you end up with that 2x2 matrix. So you write that 2x2 matrix, that is 2, negative 1. Negative 5, 6. Then you go to the next term, that is the sign is negative. You put that negative. Then you come to its correspondence, that is 3. You close the row where 3 is, the column and row where 3 is. You end up with a 2x2 matrix, this one and this one. So you come up with that 2x2 matrix, that is negative 1, 3, negative 1, 6. In this case, if you are keen enough, you see we do not multiply by the corresponding coefficients. Then you go to the next sign, that is positive. Then you form a 2x2 matrix from it. That is, the correspondence is 4. You cross the row where 4 is and the column. You end up with this 2x2 matrix. That one is negative 1, 2, 3, negative 5. Then you go to the next sign, that is negative. So you take negative. Then you form each 2x2 matrix. The 2x2 matrix shall be, you close this point, you close this row and the first column. So you end up with 3, 4, negative 5, 6 in that format. That is 3, 4, negative 5, and 6 in that one. The next sign is a positive sign, the one in the middle. After solving the positive side, you form this 2x2 matrix correspondence. So the 2x2 matrix correspondence comes in this format. So you close the position of the middle one and the middle row. You end up with 2, 4, 3, 6. So you end up with 2, 4, 3, 6. The next sign is negative. Then you form its 2x2 matrix. Then you close the middle row and the last column. You end up with 2, 3, 3, negative 5. 2, 3, 3, negative 5 in that format. Then you go to the last row of sign array. That is, the first one is positive. Get the positive sign there. Then you bring forth, you close the column and the row where that one is. That is this one and this one. You remain with 2, 3, 2, negative 1. So you have that 3, 4, 2, negative 1. The next sign is negative. You form a 2x2 matrix from that point. So you close, this negative here is here. You close the column and the row where it is. You end up with 2, negative 1, and 4, and negative 1. So that is 2, negative 1, 4, and negative 1. Then you get to the last point, that is the last sign, which is positive, and you form its 2x2 matrix. That is, you close the column and the row. You end up with 2, 3, and then negative 1, 2. So this is what we call our cofactor matrix. But you first solve this to get independent terms that are definite and self-determined. By getting the product of leading diagonal, it lies the forward diagonal. So that one shall be, this is 2x6, that one is 12. Negative 5 by negative 1, that is 5. So you minus 5. But you multiply by the sign which is outside. Then you come here. You get negative 1 by negative 6. Negative 1 by 6, so it gives you negative 6. Then 3 by negative 1 is 3, so it is negative 3. So minus minus becomes a positive. Then you multiply by the sign which is outside there. Then you go to this next term, that is negative 1, negative 5 gives you 5. 3, this gives you negatives, minus 6. Multiply by the sign which is outside, which is positive. You go to the second row, that is 3 by 6, that is 18. Negative 3 by 4, negative 5 by 4, that is negative 20. Multiply by the sign which is outside. 2 by 6, 12. 3 by 3 is 12. So 12 minus 12, this is 12 minus 12. In bracket, the sign is positive. That format will proceed. Then 2 by negative 5, that is negative 10. 3 by 3 is 9, so it is minus 9. Then the negative sign is outside. The third one is 3 by negative 1, that is negative 3. 4 by 2, 8, less 8. In that format, you maintain the sign which is positive. Then 2 by negative 1, that is negative 2. Negative 1 by 4, that is negative 4. Then minus minus makes it positive. So it is positive 4. The sign is maintained outside. Proceeding, then the last one is 2 by 2, that is 4. Negative 1 by 3, negative 3. So minus minus makes it positive. And they maintain the outside sign, which is positive. Then you can compute the independent brackets for you to be able to solve for the everything. For you to be able to solve for everything, that is by now solving the independent part. That's 12 minus 5, that is 7, times the positive sign outside, it's 7. Negative 5 my plus 3 gives you negative 3. Negative 3 times the negative sign outside gives you negative 3 times negative gives you positive 3. Then 5 minus 6 gives you negative 1 times the positive, it is still negative 1. Then negative 18 minus 20 gives you negative 2. Negative 2 times the negative sign outside gives you positive 2. Then 12 minus 12 is 0. Negative 10 minus 9 is negative 19. Times the negative sign outside, it becomes positive 19. Negative 3 minus 8 is negative 11. Times the positive sign, it still remains negative. Negative 2 plus 4 is 4. Times the negative sign outside, goes back to negative 2. Then 4 plus 3 is actually 7. So this one is what we call a cofactor matrix. The cofactor matrix. Cofactor matrix of B. That's the cofactor matrix of B. Then, after getting the cofactor matrix, we do what we call we transpose. We transpose the cofactor matrix. This is now the step 3. Transpose cofactor matrix to obtain. To obtain the adjoint of P. So transposing simply means you reverse the rows and column. So cofactor, you found that the cofactor is 7, 3, -1, 2, 0, 19, -11, 2, 7. This is the cofactor matrix. Eh? We transpose it. Transpose that one. If let's call that our cofactor matrix now to be Q. So we transpose Q. Q transpose shall be actually the our adjoint. So if we transpose, it reverses rows and column. So this row reverses the first column. So it will be 7. This term now comes down here. 7, 3. This term goes here, -11. Then all this one now goes the other side. So 2 goes there, 2 comes here, and 11 comes to that far end. Then you go to the second row. The second row, 0 and 7 still remain at that middle corner. What happens? This row was horizontal. So now you start in the middle. You start with now 2, 0, 19 comes down. This one is slipping horizontal on the bottom. So it will be standing horizontal to the last. So it will be -11, -2, 7. It's -2 here. So this one is actually the Q transpose, which is actually what we call our adjoint. This is the adjoint of P. So to get an adjoint, you could simply do, you come to the cofactor matrix, then you divide it in the diagonal, forward diagonal in this format. After doing that, you reverse it. This one comes here and that one goes. This one comes here and that one goes there. This one comes here. This one comes, 19 comes here and 2 goes there. Then the middle line remains the same. You directly obtain the adjoint. So after getting the adjoint, it is now simple. So to get the step four, the inverse of P is actually given as that P inverse is now given as 1 over the magnitude of P times the adjoint. 1 over the magnitude of P times the adjoint of P. So this one shall be equal to actually 1 over the magnitude of P we have found to be 19. So let's form it here lastly and say that the inverse of P shall be given by 1 over the magnitude of P times the adjoint. So adjoint of P, the magnitude of P we have found to be 19, and the adjoint we've gotten to be the transpose. So P inverse shall be equal to 1 over 19 multiplied by the adjoint, and the adjoint is actually this 3 by 3 matrix. That is 7, 2, negative 11. 3, 0, negative 2. Negative 19, negative 1, sorry, 19, 7. So this is actually the inverse of P. P is this one, this is its inverse. This is P. And this is the inverse of P. So for assignmental purposes, prove that P multiplied by P inverse is actually 1. Where 1 is actually a unitary matrix which can be written in this form of 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So you need to prove that the P dot P is actually that one. That is inferential. So since that we all know that any number multiplied by its inverse always give us 1. So that's how to get the inverse over 3 by 3 matrix. The inverse over 3 by 3 matrix. So let's do an example application of 3 by 3 matrix, where 3 by 3 matrix is applied to get some mathematical solutions. So let's have one here. Application of matrices to solve simultaneous equation of 3 and none. Up now, we all know how to solve a 3x3, to get the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. The steps are, you first get the magnitude, that is the determinant. The second step is, you get a cofactor matrix. Third step, you transpose the cofactor matrix to get the adjoint. Then you get the inverse as 1 over the magnitude multiplied by the adjoint gives us what we call the inverse. So, now we're going to look at application of matrices to solve simultaneous equation of three unknown. Simultaneous equation of three unknown. For example, given that x plus y plus z is equal to 2, x plus y plus z is equal to 2. Then we are also given that 3x minus 4y plus minus 4z is equal to negative 1. Then again, you are told that 2x minus 5y plus 2z is equal to negative 17. You are given this one to solve for. You are told to solve for x, y, and z. So there are methods you can use to solve this equation. You can use elimination method, you can use substitution method. But we want to now apply matrices to solve for the values of the three unknown variables. There are two methods of solving for this using matrices. The first method is what we call the using of the Cramer's rule. Number two is the use of the inverse matrix method. So the two methods give the same answer, but they involve different procedures. So let's first solve this method using what we call Cramer's rule. So Cramer's rule states that the values of the parameters x is given as, where x is the value in this equation, is given as dx, d along x, all over d. And the value of y is given as d along y all over d. Then z is given as d along z over d. Where d is actually the magnitude of the matrix. Let's suppose that the matrix is Q, is P, d will be its magnitude, and d along x, d along y, d along z is the magnitude obtained by replacing the x, y, and z column respectively and exclusively. By the output column. It might sound challenging to understand in terms of a statement, but if you execute one example, it will be more variant and will be very simple to understand. So let's form a 3x3 matrix from this one. So we can form from this equation, we can form a 3x3 matrix in this format. So this is the first column of x. You just take the coefficient correspondence. That one is 1, 3, 2. Then this column of y, you only take the coefficient. That is 1, negative 4, negative 5. Then column of z, we have got 1, negative 4, and 2. So that is our matrix. We have got x, y, and z here. So if you open this bracket, if you multiply these two, you go back to this equation. So we all know that. So this one is equal to, this is now the output column. This is the output column. So the first step we need to get, so let's call this matrix, let's call it P, just for example. So step one, to solve using Cramer's rule, step one, obtain the magnitude of P, that is the determinant. While getting the magnitude, you do not forget the sign array. This is very important in matrices, the sign array display. So you can get the magnitude, you choose any column or any row. So when you follow the sign array properly, the answers shall be the same. So but it is simple to use the first row because it is hardly confusing. So let's use the first row. While getting the determinant, you multiply by the coefficients. While getting the cofactor matrix, you ignore the coefficients, you only take the signs. So let's have our first sign is positive and the coefficient is 1. So it is positive 1. Multiply by, you cross the row and the column, you end up with this small 2 by 2 matrix. That is negative 4, negative 4, negative 5, 2. Then the second sign is 1, negative 1 into, closing the first row and the middle column, you get 3, 4, negative 4, 2, negative 2, 2. So that is 3, negative 4, 2, 2. Then again, you come to the last one, that is positive 1, into, you close the first row and the last column, you end up with 3, negative 4, 2, negative 5. 3, negative 4, 2, negative 5. In that format. So you can get the magnitude of those independent parts. That is negative 4 by 2, that is negative 8. Negative 5 by negative 4, that is 20. So it is minus 20. Sign outside is positive. Then minus 3 by 2 is 6. 2 by negative 4, that is negative 8. So negative negatives makes it positive. In that format. Then 3 by negative 5, this is positive. 3 by negative 5 is negative 15. Negative 15. 2 by negative 4 is negative 8. Minus minus makes it positive in that format. So the magnitude of P shall be equal to, this is negative 8, negative 20, that is negative 28. 6 plus 8, 14 by negative 1, that is negative 14. Then 15 by 15, negative 50 plus 8, that is negative 7 in that format. So if you add all that, you get, this is negative 21. If you minus 28, you get negative 69. Negative 69 in that format. 3, 21 to 21. 28, 9, 4, 49, not 69. Yeah, 4, 9. Negative 49 in that format. So you already now have the magnitude of P. So you get the one, you get the D along P. You get the D along P. That's by getting the determinant by replacing the last column. By replacing the last column, that one shall be, you take the column and replace it in that format. So we proceed from there.